John, it's great to be back with you at Van Horn High School 51 years after we graduated. I thought it might be a good idea to call and get my draft records and deferments from draft board number 48 on the square in Independence, where we all had to face the music, yeah, one way or the other. In Independence, Missouri, where patriotism was never hidden, we had a higher number of people, a higher percentage of people serving than the country as a whole. Is that your experience? I mean, does that surprise you at all?
No.
Why?
Almost all of our fathers were in the service. My dad was a teenage pilot in the Army Air Force in World War II. He met my mother working in a defense plant building bombs. So even my mother served her country. Almost all of our male instructors here at Van Horn had some military service. We grew up surrounded by heroes, people that we admired for their service.
My dad was a first sergeant in an Army ordnance company.
Yes.
He was proud of his service, and I was proud of him. But why, at 17, when you're probably still in this school somewhere, why did you enlist before any of us had to really deal with the draft board?
My country was at war.
And you believed in the war?
Yeah.
Even though by the time you enlisted, there was some pushback on it.
Right, but you know, there were a lot of us in our generation, probably the last, that still believed our president wouldn't lie to us. I wanted excitement. I wanted a challenge. And I felt like I had something to offer for my country. And the military offered me the opportunity to make that offering early.
Not only did you enlist, you volunteered for service in Vietnam.
Right on.
Why did you do that?
With a sense of history, the idea that I wouldn't serve when we were at war was repugnant to me. I didn't want to look in a mirror and see a guy looking back at me who hadn't done everything he could do for what he believed. I didn't want to be the guy that said, let somebody else do it.
Although there were some guys who were morally opposed to the war to the point they were willing to go to prison.
Right? Absolutely right. And that takes a tremendous amount of courage.
Yeah.
They have my respect.
I didn't serve, and I didn't protest. I relied on student deferments, and probably, given my first semester grade point average of 0.285, they should have put my butt on a bus to boot camp and didn't. I've always wondered why. How do you feel about that whole idea of guilt among those who didn't enlist or get drafted?
I lack sympathy for the young men, the men of our generation who will come up and tell me that, because I'll say, well, you had the same opportunities to enlist that I had.
You heard that from a lot of guys?
Oh,
they come up to you?
Yeah.
I wonder if the guilt gets greater for those folks as we get older and our view of the war in retrospect changes. And it has, hasn't it?
Oh, yeah. Was I've had people from our generation, young men, tell me that they didn't have really anything to do with the war because they went to college. And that infuriates me. Even to be a conscientious objector, people try to legitimize the draft by saying, well, you know, if you're really opposed, you have the option. Well, you only have the option if you're well-educated and primarily white. That black wall in Washington, D.C., is covered with thousands of names of young men who filled somebody else's slot. They reached into the homes of the poor and the working class, and they took their sons in their place. So every year, someone got a draft deferment. Someone who was poor or working class got drafted for 2 years. And if you got drafted, you were pretty much going to Vietnam in the infantry. My anger with this whole system was that it was so unfair. that the poor and the working class had to carry the burden for that war and then get blamed for it. And I will never forgive this country for that. And I'll never let them forget it. I speak out about it vehemently at any given opportunity, because we should never do it again.
But in a way, with the volunteer army, we're doing just that, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
I'm not going to tell you I'm carrying around guilt, because I know you've heard that before, but I'm going to thank you.
That I appreciate. Thanks, Mickey. It was a privilege.